Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14 Beta 8 has been out a few days. It's actually very close to, I think, a final release. I'll talk about a little bit later, as well as the GM. And I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. This is my main phone. I also use it daily on my 2020 iPad Pro 12.9. And then I also have it on the iPhone 11, 6S Plus, and iPhone 7. And so let's talk about how my experience was, how your experience was based off the YouTube community poll, performance, battery life, bugs, and more. So the first thing is I've experienced two issues. One of them was right before this video. In fact, I went into settings and it completely froze. I couldn't do anything. It wouldn't scroll. That's the first time I've seen that, but it took a few days to show up. The other thing I've had is I've had Twitter freeze on me a couple times. So I'd go into it, maybe go to messages or whatever I was doing, it would completely freeze. Now that could be a problem with the app, or it could be a problem with the phone itself with this particular beta. Most of the time it doesn't do that. Those are the only two times I've actually seen that. Other than that, I've had zero bugs with this. In fact, I've had no issues. I've had great speed and everything else, so I haven't had any issues. And quite a few of you said it runs like a GM or a final version. And so for those of you that aren't familiar, a GM or Golden Master is the final version that's released to beta testers prior to it being released to the public. And like I said, we'll talk more about that in a little bit. Now, other than the people that are saying they're not having problems, a few people were mentioning some odd problems, such as flickering displays. Now, it doesn't seem to matter which device it was on. It could be any of these really, but they were seeing flickering displays, and some people were experiencing other issues with the news widget not showing up, for example. So if you deleted the news app and then reinstalled the news app, it seems like the news widget just wouldn't show up again. It wouldn't be there. So hopefully they'll fix that pretty soon. Now, some other people were actually saying that they were having connectivity issues. So maybe it's with Wi-Fi or LTE. Usually it's with LTE, it seems like. There's more people talking about that. So if you're having connectivity issues, hopefully there'll be a modem update that fixes this by the time it's released to the public. So hopefully we'll see that. Now, other people are saying that they're experiencing the keyboard freezing. So if you were in the keyboard, for example, and typing, it just wasn't working. I personally haven't seen this, but I know quite a few people that have said they have. Also, some people are saying they're having Face ID issues. So for example, when you go into Face ID, it would present a problem, whether or not that means it just doesn't unlock, or maybe it's because you're using a mask and it's not seeing you properly. So that makes sense. Usually it won't work with a mask unless it's really thin. Otherwise, you'll have to put in your passcode. But most of the time, people aren't having issues with Face ID, but a few are. Other people are seeing issues with notifications. So notifications coming in are not working for some people, and they seem to be working okay for me, but they're saying they're showing up late or not showing up at all. So I'm seeing this multiple times throughout the comments on the community poll. And then finally, people are reporting issues with battery as well as charging issues. Now, battery life for me has been okay. If we take a look at the settings here, we'll go down to battery and you'll see my battery health is still at 96%. And let's go over to the last 10 days. So if we take a look at yesterday, I used 50% of my battery and I got 4 hours and 5 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 4 minutes of screen off time. So it's actually doing pretty well. The odd thing is it says Nest Audio and I wasn't using Nest. So that's kind of interesting. I'm not sure why it's there. Maybe it didn't close in the background like it should have, but that's kind of strange that it was actually saying that. So there's definitely some issues with this, although 4.5 hours of screen on time and 6 hours of screen off time with 50% battery usage is actually quite good for a beta. So 9 or 10 hours, 10 to 12 is normal, like I've said many times. So I hope to see this improved in the future. Now, the other people that were having issues with this actually charging. So it either wasn't charging properly or it would stop at 80%, similar to what optimized battery charging would do, but it wouldn't function properly. And so hopefully this will be fixed soon. I think Apple's just really fixing those additional bugs before they release it to the public, but it seems like they'll hopefully get that nailed down pretty quickly. Now, performance overall on the newer phones is fine, and the same is true of older phones. So performance on older phones such as the 6S Plus here seem to be fine. It's smooth, just like you would expect. In fact, don't expect it to be slower than iOS 13, for example. You'll see it's just loading through Wi-Fi there. Let's scroll, and you'll see scrolling is okay. It's fine. It's completely usable. No issues here. So if we go to settings, I haven't had any freezing on this device either. And then the iPhone 11, which is actually the device most of you are using, and I'll talk about that with the statistics in a moment, but this device is nice and fast. No issues here whatsoever. It feels like you're using an 11 Pro Max. So no issues with performance. And most of you have said the same thing other than the few that were saying it was freezing. Now, as far as iPadOS, well, my iPad, honestly, I've had zero problems with iPadOS Beta 8. In fact, it's been incredibly stable. Zero problems, zero freezing, zero lag, and 4K YouTube and everything is working just fine. Now, that's up to YouTube whether or not they enable it. It seems to be working just fine. I've never had any issues. You'll see how smooth and fast it is with this 120 hertz display. No issues whatsoever. So if you have anything from an iPhone 7, to the latest 11 Pro Max, performance should be pretty good. Now, should you install iOS 14 Beta 8? Well, I would say if you haven't already, you definitely should. It's better than the other betas by far, in my opinion. It's as stable as can be, and we're very close to a GM or Golden Master version, like I mentioned earlier. So based off today here, you'll see I record these a little ahead of time, but based off today, I would say that Apple is going to release the GM after the Apple event on Tuesday. So on the 15th, expect the Gold Master or Golden Master, and then probably the week of the 20th, we'll see the final release. Usually that's on a Friday when they do that or a Thursday, but they could release it earlier in the week. If my memory serves me correctly, it may have been earlier in the week, but either way, it will be released to the public probably in this week. And then we'll see iOS 14.1, maybe later on. Some people have said that that will come out once the iPhone 12 launches. So whether or not we see a launch at this week's event is hard to say, but I just can't wait to see what we have at that event. Now, here are all the different issues that people have mentioned based off the YouTube community poll. So quite a few people mentioning battery, whether that's good or bad. People are saying RAM management is good. Most people are saying freezing or lag, and a few people were having notification issues with mail, like I said before, just notifications in general also. Now, here are all the devices you're using based off the poll. Now, iPhone 11 is the number one used device, it seems, based off the community poll, so it makes sense. It's the least expensive, newest device, so if you want to see more of that in the videos, let me know in the comments below. Now, let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now, at the time of this video, you can see there's 11,000 votes, which is pretty incredible, I think, and 318 comments where I got all the information from before. 40% of you said it was great, 3% said it was terrible, 9% said okay, but some bugs, and 48% of you have not upgraded yet. So I think it's getting a little bit better. If we look at the previous poll, go back to beta 7, you'll see still 3% said terrible, but only 9% versus 11 this time said it had bugs, 40% are saying it's great. So I think overall, this one is actually doing pretty well. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. Bruce Hemer says, using an iPhone 8 Plus running iOS 14 Beta 8, the phone app crashes, devised a workaround by calling from either the Contacts app or iMessage app, but direct dial is unavailable because it lies within the phone app. Make sure you report that to the feedback app. Of course, if others are having this, it's a major bug. Thankfully, you're the only one I've heard of having it, so maybe a reboot would fix it. I'm not sure, but hopefully it's not a major issue within the OS. Angel or Angle Valera says, iPhone 11 Pro Max, everything runs well. Battery is excellent. However, having connectivity issues, sometimes web pages just hang, then 3 to 4 seconds later, load. In other cases, even with full bars, nothing loads at all. On Verizon, and thanks for the great video. Gurdeep Singh says, iPhone 10, performance, stability, and battery are great on this beta. William 100 said, battery in my 8 Plus is draining a little too quick still. Otherwise, I really like it. Christopher Rodriguez says, performing great on my iPhone 11. Armin Alexandrian said, no real complaints. iPhone 11 Pro Max, smooth and snappy. Rajath Menon says, running it on my iPhone SE first gen, performance is smooth overall and battery life has definitely improved. The only issue I'm facing right now is that the app library stutters when scrolling. This problem has persisted ever since public beta 3 for me. Not sure if it's ever going to be fixed. LP Photography said, it's doing great on my 6S. Brian Sousa says, still having issues with my news widget not showing up on my 11 Pro Max. Tricky said, my iPhone XR is running smooth on iOS 14 Beta 8, and the same goes for the iPad 7 on iPadOS 14 Beta 8. Can't wait for the GM. Master Savage said, iOS 14 has to be the best beta of all of them. No annoying bugs. I have iOS 14 Beta 8 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It is an absolutely amazing software, and I'm looking forward to the GM. Broly said, iPhone 6S here. Seems like my phone is getting hotter more often than it was on iOS 13.7. I've encountered a few UI glitches, and one bug I've had in particular is not being able to enable availability alerts for exposure notifications. It says location services is off when it's all turned on. I've reported any bugs I've found in the feedback app, though. That is actually related directly to whether or not you have an app in your area or location. If you do, it should be available. If not, it won't be available. Code Geek said it's running smoothly on my iPod Touch 7th gen with no issues. Thank you for saying all of the features on these betas. And thank you for watching. Teacher York says iOS Beta 8 on my iPhone 8 Plus has been really smooth. Only my battery tends to drain slightly quicker than usual, and I haven't seen any degrade in my battery health from 90%, so I know it's a software problem. Thank you. Nikitesh Moses says, I'm using an iPhone XR. I have issues with the music. It's not running in the background with some apps, and some third-party apps also not working, which is working with my other SE with iOS 13.7. Rajko says, hi Aaron, there is still an annoying bug with a clock widget and brightness on the control center. The big difference compared to beta 7 in terms of speed and stability. We will still maybe have another beta, and this one is almost like GM. We'll see. Rem's Rhythm says, really good on my iPhone 10. Back tap works a lot better now, and battery life has improved still, not at iOS 13 level, but getting there. Elvin says, battery performance has been markedly improved. Notice some lag between cellular and Wi-Fi, SWAPA and vice versa, although modem firmware has been the same in the last three betas. Let's wait for the GM candidate, hopefully coming next week. Jaime Garcia says, some visual bugs for me, but they go as soon as you swipe the page. Everything else is fine. iPhone 11. Thomas Van Gorkum says, it's doing great on my iPhone XR, although battery life isn't the best. Hopefully they'll fix that soon. And then finally, Lord YT says, it's running very smooth on my iPhone 7, and I've noticed some improvements for my battery and also the performance. So that's it for iOS 14 Beta 8. Again, look for a GM, hopefully in a few days, along with that Apple event, which I'll have a video updating that on Monday, talking about everything to expect and even more. So be sure to check back for that. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.